Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Megha. I am a student of PH second year, and today I am here to discuss the significance of role play in science pedagogy. Science is a very vast subject. We get to know about the cause and effect relationship of the processes and phenomena happening around us. We have also heard about the quote that everything is theoretically impossible until it is done. We generally say that things are not possible, but when we have to do it, we have will to do it, we perform it, and things become experimentally possible. Role play as a teaching method. Science teaching through role play allows the children to act out, make sense of the real life situations, and they explore, investigate, and experiment. It also helps in demonstrating their understanding and explore their views, developing deeper understanding of the phenomena. Today's topic is taken from class 8 NCERT textbook. The topic for today is atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure refers to the pressure exerted by the atmosphere. Now, let us understand it by watching a small magic show. The magic show is all about... No, I will not tell you. Firstly, we should watch it. Here, we are watching a short magic show. A magician is filling the glass of water and taking a cardboard, and she has inverted the glass of water on the cardboard. Now, what do you think? What will happen? The cardboard should fall down as she removes her hand. But wait, what did I tell you? That it is magic show. So, some magic will happen and this glass of water or the cardboard will not fall down. The cardboard will not fall down. Look, how is it possible? Look, it does not fall. Neither a drop of water nor the cardboard is falling down. You can see it is a very good phenomenon. You can even experiment it at home. The reason behind this, the force caused by the atmospheric pressure on the surface of the cardboard is greater than the weight of the water in the glass. I hope you understood. Thank you.
I hear and I forget, I see and I remember, I do and I understand. Keeping this statement in mind, every teacher devises his or her good effective method for teaching, and one of the method is role play. Role playing is an educational technique that allows students to explore realistic situations by interacting with each other in a managed way in order to develop experience. But why role play? Because it helps to develop all domains of learning, cognitive, psychomotor, and affective. It's also a lot of fun and helps to shake off those classroom cobwebs. It involves manipulating knowledge in an exciting way. And it also helps in developing sympathetic understanding among students. Role play in English language teaching. Role play is an effective technique to animate the teaching and learning atmosphere. It arouses the interest of learner and make the language acquisition impressive. Incorporating role play into the classroom adds variety, a change of pace, and provides opportunity for a lot of language learners. It is also a lot of fun, thus it makes the whole language learning process more pragmatic. Role play method makes the learning of language acquisition more simpler through purposeful communication and teamwork. It also helps in improving communication skills by focusing on pronunciation, choice of word, grammar, and so forth.
Hello. Good afternoon, sir. Thank you for calling to Airtel Service Center. How may I help you?
Yeah. Hello. Yes. Actually, ma'am, I awaited for your call in services last week. It hasn't been addressed or reverted.
Sorry for the delay caused in the initiation of your services, sir. Is this the same mobile number you opted for the services?
Yes, ma'am. It's the same number. Yes, ma'am.
Could you please tell me the caller tune that you opted for the activation process, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Please note. It's quit playing games with my heart. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
A very good morning to all of you. I am Abhishek Chaudhary, student of James B.Ed. second year. Today, I would like to present a significance of role play in pedagogical practices. And my pedagogy subject is social science. What is role play? Role play is a technique that allows a student to explore realistic situations by interacting with other people in a managed way in order to develop experience and trail different strategies in supported environment. Secondly, I would like to tell you about what is social science. A social science is the branch of science devoted to the study of societies and the relationship among individuals within those societies. The term was formerly used to refer the field of sociology. Today's topic is rulers and buildings of class 7th. I have chosen Taj Mahal for this role play.
Wait. मैं इसके बारे में आपको बोल कर नहीं बल्कि करके दिखाऊंगा, तो आइए देखते हैं। चलिए ना। वाव, क्या खूबसूरत नजारा है, क्या बात है, क्या चीज है। शायद इसलिए लोगों ने इसको दुनिया का सातवां जू कहा है। क्या बात है, ताजमहल बहुत बढ़िया। लेकिन मुझे इसके बारे में बताएगा कौन? मुझे इसके बारे में जानना है, मुझे इसकी हिस्ट्री के बारे में जानना है। ये क्यों बना, किस लिए बना, कौन बताएगा? आइडिया, टूरिस्ट गाइड। मैं हूं ना राजा बाबू, मैं आपको ताजमहल की खूबसूरती और उसके इतिहास के बारे में बताऊंगा। मैं यहाँ का बहुत ही फेमस गाइड हूँ, मैं आज आपको ताजमहल के बारे में बताऊंगा। जैसा कि मैं आपको बता रहा था ताजमहल के बारे में, ताजमहल जिसको दुनिया के सातवें अजूबों में से एक माना जाता है और इसको इंडिया के सर का ताज भी कहा जाता है। हाँ, द क्राउन ऑफ इंडिया इसी को कहा जाता है। आपको पता है ताजमहल क्यों बना था? मैं बताता हूँ। ताजमहल को शाहजहां ने अपनी बेगम मुमताज महल की याद में बनवाया था। 1632 में इसका काम शुरू हुआ और तकरीबन 22 साल लगे इसको पूरा होने में और 1662 में जाके ये कंप्लीट हुआ था। और आपको पता है इसकी लागत उस टाइम पर 1632 में 3 करोड़ रुपए आई थी और इसमें दुनिया के सबसे बेहतरीन पत्थरों में से एक संगमरमर पत्थर लगा हुआ है, जिससे इसकी शोभा और भी बढ़ जाती है और ये और खूबसूरत होता है। और ताजमहल का शिल्पकार उस्ताद लाहौरी ने किया था। और आपको पता है कि ताजमहल को हिंदुओं का शिव मंदिर भी कहा जाता है, जिसका नाम है तेजो महल्य। ये था ताजमहल का इतिहास और उसकी सुंदरता। तो देखा आपने किस तरह रोल प्ले मेथड को क्लास में यूज करके हम किसी भी सब्जेक्ट को या किसी टॉपिक को इंटरेस्टिंग बना सकते हैं और लर्निंग को इम्प्रूव कर सकते हैं।
Role playing is defined as pretending to be someone else or pretending to be in a specific situation that we are not actually in at that time. If we talk about the teaching and learning process, role playing is a technique that allows the students to explore the realistic situation by interacting with other people in a specified way in order to develop the experiences and skills. About the significance of role playing method, then it's going to be noted that role playing is not only effective for the students but as well as for the teachers. As when the teacher is using role playing method in the classroom environment becomes positive as the student gets active in the learning. And
when we talk about the student's perspective, then all the three domains that are defined in Bloom's taxonomy, that is cognitive, psychomotor and affective domain, all three domains are covered in the role-playing method. Also, when the students imitate or pretend to be someone else or pretend to be someone in a specific situation, then their creativity gets improved. Also, their communication skills gets improved and their confidence level becomes high. That is very important in today's time. Also, when students work in a group, their group cohesiveness improves. We also learn that how they need to behave in the society and in the group. We also promote the principle of learning by doing. With this, I remember a very good quote presented by Confucius that I hear and I forget, I see and I remember, but when I do, I understand. So this is what the role-playing method presents to us. Let's explain this with an example. So let's get started.
मैं हूँ यहाँ का राजा, यहाँ के हर एक घर का बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट मेंबर हूँ मैं। पता है क्यों? क्योंकि यहाँ सभी लोगों की सुबह भी मुझी से होती है और शाम भी मुझसे ही होती है। लोगों के घर की सुबह और शाम तुमसे हुआ करती थी। अब इन सब के घर का नया मेंबर कौन है? मैं। सो आगे आने वाले टाइम का राजा कौन हुआ? मैं ही हुआ ना। तुम मेरी जगह लेने की कोशिश कर रहे हो? मेरी? पर मैं ऐसा बिल्कुल नहीं होने दूंगा। क्या कर लोगे? हर किसी के पास मुझ जैसा दिमाग कहाँ, जो तुमसे कम दाम में और अच्छे अच्छे ऑफर्स के साथ इस मार्केट में आके तुम्हारी डिमांड को छीन लिया। अब मैं तुझे मजा चखाऊंगा।
दिया, मैं 1+1 कर देता हूँ, फिर से मेरी डिमांड भर जाएगी।
So, this is what we understand by monopolistic competitive market, where we have large number of buyer section and large number of seller section available in the market. But they are having differentiated products that are closely substitute but not a perfect one. As we see in our example, there are two toothpaste brands and both are competing with each other. But the main thing to be noticed here is that they are having a non-price competition. Because if they keep on cutting their price down, then initially both will suffer the loss. And this is not the reason they are in the market. So that is why they have to make some difference in their product. Another thing you can see is that their market strategies are different. One is promoting their product, coming newly in the market with lower prices. And when other wants to know that its market share isn't lost, then idea gets generated and they launch a scheme. Buy one, get one. This is what the marketing strategy is.
So we can say that monopolistic market is a mix of both the market, monopoly as well as perfectly competitive market, as it comprises the characteristics of both the market. And in the concluding remarks, we can also say that role-playing method of teaching is a very effective method of teaching. It is helpful not only for the primary classes but also for the senior secondary classes, and it should be adopted by the teachers effectively. Thank you so much.